Well, clear this table.
Yeah, I know, the bit of clutter,
isn't it? Queer messy.
Queer messy. Leave that slang alone.
Does queer messy that?
What's queer messy?
It's a Carlo Wexford way of saying real.
It's
pure.
Really dirty.
Somebody posted something on my page there today. Mm. Oh, we're going live. Here we go. I'll show you in a second. Look at me there. Right, so now we'll wait for people to come in. I apologise in advance for not shaving. Unfortunately, I spent the entire day doing absolutely nothing.
Chilling out.
Actually, would you believe, you know how bad before even the news today, I decided I was going to have a me day today. Everybody was at school and a me day, just for me. And ordered a pizza, I had a big bottle of Pepsi, and I sat down and watched the third season of Star Wars Rebels. Oh, hello, we got three people watching.
Lily.
Oh, hello, Lily. How are you?
Yeah, she's giving out that you weren't there, weren't here.
Hey, Lily,
really,
I got Swedish
food
tonight.
Yeah.
Right.
That's fun.
Somebody has posted this on my page.
Attention.
Little Bird taught me...
Nice. Can you put that on Carlo FM?
I will. Little Bird
at least could add at least one new member.
Do I look 90?
You probably feel it.
I feel it. I do. I fear enough. I do feel it. What am I needing to do? I need to... Hello, everybody. Hello to Darren O'Neill. Welcome. Hello to Lisa Hurley. How are you,
Lisa?
You're
actually 3 minutes onto the air.
Yeah. I'm 3 minutes onto the air.
He's only 50 seconds in that.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. Have I done that? Right, we need to mute that. Sorry, lads. Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to another Sunday Night Mixtape. No, it's not Sunday, actually. It's Wednesday.
No, it's not. It's Wednesday. It's the Wednesday mayhem.
There we go. I've got the whole days mixed up so badly that I thought it was Sunday Night Mixtape.
It's other sweets are available, show.
No, other days are available as well, including Sundays.
It's the others right. Are available, show.
I would like... Now, things we're going to be talking about today. Apparently, God sake...
Interrupted
for
already.
For God's sake. Wait for it. I have a point. For God's sake.
Go on.
A woman's place is meant to be in the kitchen.
Did you say that to your wife?
Hold on.
Did you say that to your wife?
Wait for it.
Go on.
A woman's place is meant to be in the kitchen, for God's sake. Now, the reason why I've said that is because apparently they're going to repeal the Constitution. What?
Lisa Hurley said, may the force be with you.
And may God be with you. Now, listen to me.
Go on.
The Irish government now wish to repeal the amendment. So
I got it. Oh, yes, I heard that.
The blasphemy law shall be repealed.
Oh, God's sake.
I'm
sorry, I'm touching the wrong one.
I'm going to
turn the volume down.
Right, have you got that there, Jerry? You do. Right, so... No. Listen... It turns out that the Irish government want to repeal the blasphemy law and one other which stated that...
Can you explain that to me, the blasphemy law?
Well, apparently you can't talk about God in that particular way. Now, who was the guy that was in... Let me get his name for you, right? The blasphemy law. He was an English actor. Hugh Laurie. I think it was Hugh Laurie.
Hugh?
Hugh Laurie was being interviewed on the Gay Byrne show, I believe. And he was talking about God in such a disrespectful way, and he nearly got done for being blasphemous in Ireland, which is it's kind of an offence, a prisonable offence.
Right.
It's fine.
Is it? Okay.
Now,
well,
my idea...
That's us, then.
That's us, you know. Now, my idea is this, and this is me being very unconstitutional. Get rid of the Constitution altogether.
No, just get rid of the fools up there.
Get rid of it and start again. What?
I'm Jerry Birdie here.
Hold on.
Oh, mister.
May the force be with you and also with you. Do you know when you're in mass?
It's not my show.
But do you know when you're in mass?
Oh, for God's sake, Lisa. Yes, Lisa, yeah.
I know
exactly how you feel, yeah.
Do you know what? It would be great. I mean, we're such a religious community. Why didn't they name their children Jesus? When you look out the window and you say, Mary, Michael, Lisa, get in for your dinner, and the whole entire neighbourhood comes over for their dinner. So why is it that they've never actually named their children Jesus? Anyhow, look, we're going to be, we are going live on Carlo FM, we're going live on Facebook, we're going live on 88.1 FM, so wherever you are, we're there, you can't get away from us. Let me just pop you over there, thank you very much, and I can see you right there. Now, right, I did go a little late over.
Over 5 minutes.
No. Jerry joined and I joined this.
Jerry joined what?
There, look.
No, hold on. Look at the time. Almost 5 past. Yeah. You still haven't even played the promo. Did you stop?
No, the promos did play. Actually, do you know what?
No, they didn't.
No, the promos didn't even kick in.
They did, they're there.
Yeah, but they never kicked in.
Yeah, because you didn't play. Because you stopped it.
You stopped it. So, Furlong is watching it all. Do you know what? 2FM wanted to hire me now. They're in a big trouble, aren't they?
Anyway. They're in big trouble because they're not
paying me. Can I just mention
this? Yes, you can.
There's Rod.
Go on.
Whenever you get the time, Mr. Producer. Because it is your show.
Mr. Producer.
It is your show, not mine.
Right.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it?
Go on. Is it? Who's joining us? Go on. Mr. Go on, talk away.
Mr. Producer. No. Can you do... we just want to know, why is there... I was asked the question as well, so I'm going to relay it.
What's the question?
So basically speaking, why does Carlo have crossings?
Crossings?
On roundabouts.
Pedestrian crossings on roundabouts.
Pedestrian crossings on roundabouts. So we all stop on the roundabout, do we?
Where's the crossings on roundabouts?
Everywhere coming in on the ring road.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
Yeah, they're all on it. Yeah. Every
well, they're kind of up a bit.
They're within 10 feet of it.
I had to ram on because there was some silly gob balloon.
Hey, hold on. No. Stop a minute. Oh. Liz is going to leave us because she's going to go to do swimming aerobics.
For what?
She's going to
swimming aerobics.
Lisa, you should
hold on. You can just
take
us on your phone.
Hang on there for a second now. Swimming aerobics.
Yeah.
Could you not just get the paddling pool and start from outside?
Yeah, there you go. You know, what's that? Buy a Pris video vile converter. That's a vile converter.
Huh.
What? Now, look, Lisa, you can always catch us up.
What converter? What are you on about?
There.
Can I just say something, right?
I have a slight dyslexia.
Slight?
Yeah, slight. Right. Now, when I saw Trial of Prison Video, I saw... you see that too, do you?
That's up on the screen.
It's a file converter, yeah.
No, I thought it said your free trial of porn video. I thought Damien had porn on his video.
No, we're not allowed.
No, we're not allowed.
No,
anyway,
other videos are available.
Can we just mention...
On YouTube.
Can we just mention... can we just mention that I am on at 9 o'clock?
Oh, right, yes. Jerry's on 9 o'clock. By the way,
yes.
Do you like the fact that you can see all three of us now?
Yes, it's on.
Yes.
Yeah, but we're not saying where we got it from. Now, can we also...
I bought it!
We invested in new software.
We have other sweets are available tonight.
And we have other biscuits.
And we have lovely biscuits. And for the sake of some people out there who did ask me the other night, we have returned with the Toblerone.
If you ring us, right, the 1 millionth person that ring us,
I donate 5 million.
No. The 1 millionth person that rings us on 085-167-67 gets this.
3-8. Don't forget about the 3-8.
Oh, there's a 3-8 at the back. Now, not 3-8s. You're not getting 3-8s. You're getting the full
Jesus
thing.
Jesus, I love you. God, you're handsome tonight.
Did you see the way I held that?
Lily!
I'm fat and I'm trying to lose weight. Alice, don't be saying that.
Fat. I'm trying to lose weight. There's no woman fat.
Excuse me.
See that one?
Look at that. There's after the baby. There's pregnant.
Yeah.
There's after the baby.
Yeah.
Okay? That was triplet.
No.
Amberine.
Stand up for it.
Amberine in your
right, now, do it again. That's your baby. Total eclipse. Food, total eclipse.
Hi guys, Mimi McLachlan. How are you doing?
Hello, Manny.
Hello. Listen, Lizzie. Oh no, hang on now. No, it's not.
If somebody comes in the middle of that sentence, it sees me doing that.
See that? That's a squeezy chocolate. No, it's not.
No, it's not.
That's a squeezy marshmallow. right?
Other sweets are available.
Yeah, hang on now for a second now.
So it's great.
Look at that, look. You see, it goes in and out like it squeezes like that. See it?
No, you may do it closer to the camera. Mirror shot.
But you do it. So you see, you do that like that. It's squeezy.
See that? See? Just like my belly.
Yeah. It's like his belly.
Holy small.
I was gonna say it was like something else.
What?
No, you don't want to say that.
No. We've already seen enough of the porn up there now.
I wasn't gonna mention Lily. Anyway, that's not the point. No.
It looks like one of those things you can buy.
Bernie Moroni Dyer says, "Hi guys, you're so funny." You think so, Bernie?
At least it says it's a great
We're actually very concerned here.
Yes.
Well, I'm very concerned.
Yes.
Because
what I call a meat wagon,
is known as an ambulance, went down, but it was a private ambulance.
Okay.
And I'm worried that the guys in white suits are going to get out and come in and take us off.
Lisa Hurley, you're not fat. I can assure you, you're not fat, Lisa.
A private ambulance.
You're not as bad as me.
Yeah, there's no taxi plate on the top of it.
No, that's called a hearse.
Oh, that's what it is.
Come here.
Lisa, you're not.
You're buying away stuff.
Lisa says, oh, Christ. No, you're not. Don't worry. And also don't worry about the blasphemy law. It'll be gone soon. So
yeah. Just watch here. It'll definitely won't be gone.
Now, as I said, my plan is basically they should get rid of the constitution. Now, I know it's bad to say that, and I'll probably be done for blasphemy. Oh, no, not in a few months.
No.
But what I think is they need to reinvent a brand new one based on modern traditions.
Right.
Like what?
Well, first of all, the woman's place is obviously not in the home.
Okay. Yeah.
You
know, I'm not going to comment on that.
The woman's place is out there earning the job.
No, well, some people would think it would be barefoot, pregnant, tied to the sink with four kids.
Well, I think I think it's our turn to give birth to the babies and be tied to the sink and stay at home all day.
No, you're all right.
I think it is. Do you think it is? I think it's time that we were tied to the kitchen. I would be.
Would we do that for him?
Would you?
No, would we do that for me?
Oh, hold on.
Oh, yes.
Enough, lads.
Oh, for Mammy McLaughlin.
Lads, we got a message here.
Yeah, for Mammy McLaughlin. I'll go on and do it.
Go on, do it.
Could you mention the show in Stonehaven? You're supposed to continue after I said Stowe and you go, hey, never mind.
All right, go on.
Start that again. Could you mention the show in Stonehaven this Saturday at 10 p.m? Classic hits from the 70s and the 80s, plus Neil Diamond's greatest hit. What, is Neil Diamond not a classic?
Well, he is a classic.
Is there something special about Neil Diamond?
Which Stonehaven?
Who did Sweet Caroline? Sweet Caroline.
Who what?
It's what's his name?
Neil Diamond.
Yeah, but not only Neil Diamond.
No,
it was Tom Jones.
No, Neil Diamond.
Yeah,
no,
Tom Jones done
now,
as well.
I fell in love with a girl called Caroline a long time ago.
Yeah,
right?
Neil Sedaka's the original.
And I wrote her a love letter. Not a French letter.
We're getting away from the French letter.
Yeah,
right,
I wrote her a love letter. I fell in love with this girl called Caroline, and it was in the youth centre, and she was...
Get me out of the house. Baby steps with my agoraphobia.
There we go. Yeah. That's a good way to get out of the house. You're not too far from the Shannon there now, Lisa. Not that I could have jumped
Lisa
in there.
Lisa says she's fat.
She's not.
She's plump. I don't know her, so just...
I'm plump. Smokey, Bernie Mulrooney.
Smokey,
Bernie. Yeah. Bernie, it's 999, and you asked for the fire brigade if you're in Carlo, and if you're in the Leith side, you ask for the Kilkenny one. Okay, she said she's smoking.
And if you don't get any, you just ask for a hearse.
Musical interlude coming up now with a bit of music.
Absolutely. Yeah. Do you know what?
After the promos,
I'm kind of thinking what I'm going to be playing. What's the first song? You know. What? Oh, I found the perfect song.
Go on.
Do they know it's Christmas time again?
We were asked when we were going to play Christmas.
This is in my March file.
Yeah.
Why is that in March file? I don't know.
But we were asked when we were going to do some Christmas stuff.
Were
we? I was on Monday night.
Right, look, do you know what to do? Put it to the vote. Do you want to hear a Christmas tune?
Yes.
In the middle of June.
Go on.
Do you want to hear a Christmas tune in the middle of June?
085-167-6738. Facebook Live is...
Okay, yes. That didn't even rhyme. My one rhymed. You're doing so well.
Tinkerbird says hello to you. Blow a kiss.
Say hello to me, blow a kiss.
No.
Do you know what?
She must have from Anthony.
Do you know what? Do you know what?
Sorry, sorry.
I know what?
Pixie dot. Tinkerbell and her pixie dot.
Well, I tell you what, listen. I tell you what, I'll dedicate a song to her, The Swingers, and
no, you don't.
I sure tell that's you. The oldest swinger in town.
Who?
That, so that's not the song that you're going to pick?
It's called The Swingers and Beats, Counting the Beats.
Oh, okay, alright then.
Alright, we can do that.
And if you want a Christmas tune. Okay, my dyslexia.
I'm being boned.
My dyslexia kicked in again, Lisa. I thought you said you're being boned.
What?
It says I'm big boned. I thought she said.
Oh, Jesus!
He's being boned.
Oh, sorry, Lisa.
He's got
a little bit of hanky panky before the water sports.
He's got book. Water sports.
You got four screens.
Gorgeous song. Gorgeous song.
Music.
Gorgeous song.
Music.
Oh, good Lord. We got no sound.
Because your mics are on.
Because your mute is on. Air is on.
Ah.
Your
air is on. There we go.
What the hell is going on? What? I don't know.
Sorry, Lisa. There we go. Coming up now, we have Counting the Beats by The Swingers, and this one goes out to Tinkerbell.
Right, turn it down in here now, in case we get...
Ooh, okay. I don't know if I should play this after what I just said.
What's that?
Can you turn
it? Don't push it, don't force it.
Can you put the air down?
No.
No!
No!
Not that one.
Not that one.
This one here?
Yeah.
Don't push it, don't force it.
Oh yeah.
Oh, after what I just said.
You are being bold tonight,
can we,
boys.
We're still looking for Christmas outfits.
No, that's just us.
Were you this bold when I wasn't here the other day?
No.
No.
So you've been bold tonight, boys.
Yeah, because we're talking about...
Bernie Doyle says we're being bold.
No, that's just
We're talking about getting boned, which I thought I...
That's no, you didn't say you were getting boned. Hang on a
minute. I saw... Listen, it says, I'm being boned. I thought it says, I'm being boned.
Yeah, that's what it but it was.
And then I saw something here that says, don't push it, don't force it. And then I said to Lisa, I said, sure, can't you jump into Shannon? There's plenty of water games.
Water sports.
Which is also another reference to being boned.
Right, okay.
And that's why Bernie says, you're being bold tonight.
Why is Lisa saying weak?
Weak, it's a limerick thing. It means I have never heard something so funny in my life.
Oh.
And also, something else as well, you need to learn limerick terms.
Pissing myself
there
laughing.
There you go.
Yeah.
I heard that the other
night. Or roll on the floor laughing.
Yeah.
PMSL.
There you go.
R.
Or you can also say this.
FL.
You can also say this. FCUK. FCUK.
Yeah.
Fresh Connection UK. It's a brand.
Okay.
You thought I was saying.
No, we didn't.
You thought I was
all
saying
the
other
F.
Yeah.
All the words are available.
I'm going to go make myself tea. Do you want a fresh coffee?
Yes, of course I do.
Because
I can't eat
biscuits without a cup of tea.
So if you want, saving myself, if you want a Christmas tune in the middle of June, you know what to do.
Other songs are available. Yes.
Other songs are available. But if you'd like to hear it, I've got one lined up, and it's because Do You Know It's Not Quite Christmas Yet by Band-Aid.
By who?
Band-Aid.
I used to use them when I used to get cut.
Yeah, me too. Used to be a tissue paper and a bit of gaffer tape as well.
Other Toblerone bars are available.
Is there? Do you know what I would do with a Toblerone bar?
I know what I'd do with it.
No, do you know what I would do with it? Right. I would get a hacksaw.
I did.
Oh,
hang on.
It's okay. Computer games is up next time. Right. Now, since we went live on Carlo Live Video, and we are going live at the moment, I seem to be neglecting my my radio audience, if there's anybody out there. Is there anybody out there? Who sang the song? Is there anybody out there?
That wasn't in
Willy
Wonka in the chocolate
factory. No. Pink Floyd.
All right. Okay.
These lads know nothing about music, do they?
No.
No. As I was saying, what I would do with this is I would get a hacksaw and I would cut it down the middle. And what happens when you do that? If I cut this down the middle, what do I have?
You have half a Toblerone.
No. Better than that. I've got two halves of a Toblerone, and they're both triangles.
Yeah.
So I would take that up to
street. And the other triangle.
And I would sell them for twice the price.
She went jingle jangle.
Okay. Keep doing that, and watch what happens. Oh, things in the way. It looks like he was doing something naughty with his hands.
No, I wasn't.
Oh, I need another number 3 and a number 2 haircut up there.
Can be arranged in 2 minutes.
Yeah, we can do it on
we can do
live
it live for you.
Yeah, live on air we can do
will
it.
You put away,
will you put
your
away
PWR
that
door right there, will you?
Please.
For all
we know, the robber could be inside
right now. Let's see if what are you watching?
It wasn't me.
What? There we go. We got our technical team in at the moment, and
oh, yeah,
they're trying to sort things out. Normally, we don't have this. We have it even worse. So it's very quiet tonight. Actually, it's quite loud. What are you watching?
We're watching things.
Oh, we're watching
Rescue Bots.
Rescue Bots,
which is basically a ripoff of
Transformers.
Yeah, pretty much. Now, let's see. That's a song that I was going
there
to play.
There's no internet connection.
Laughing my ass off is another one. LMAO, laughing my ass off. The one that people hate me saying, and I've unfortunately.
Lisa already wants Pink Floyd.
She wants Pink. No, she said it is Pink Floyd. Is there anybody out there? See, I do know my music.
Oh, that's Pink Floyd.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have a clue about that.
I wouldn't either, but I knew it. Anyhow, Bernie Maloney Doyle says, that's what I was going to
ask you.
To play that song. Which song, Bernie? Which song would you like me to play for you? Comfortably Numb, what a classic. Oh, yeah, that is an absolute classic. Comfortably Numb. Oh, hello. That's the admin team outside. They're taking your phone calls now. The number, of course, is 085-167-6738.
Still have no idea.
Still have no idea. No, I don't. Hello there. How are you, Mr. Spider-Man? Hello. How are you? How are you?
Just
say hello.
She wants to show you his new haircut.
Oh my goodness. I want a haircut just like that. What do you think?
You have to have hair first.
Oh, ha. Oh, ha. I have never been so offended in my entire life.
Stick around.
It's early night tonight, folks.
It's still early.
Look, now, I'm the only one who's wearing his hop.
Oh, you're not going to be doing any striptease now, I hope. Now, listen to me.
No.
I have another song here, and it came in from.
You
want
to see what your sister's wearing?
Another song came in from Michael from Bagnallstown, and he's asked me.
Bagnallstown.
How did you say it?
Bagnallstown. He's asked me to play a song called My Lips Are Sealed.
I wish they were.
Well, is that a reference, Michael? My Lips Are Sealed. And this, of course, is by The Go-Go's. Stay tuned here on Carlo FM. We got a lot more songs coming up here online,
really?
On radio.
You'll be lucky.
I'll be lucky if I can get through half of them.
Mere music, now let's chat. But good stuff.
Hi, sis.
Mere music, now. Was it? M-R-E music, N-D.
Mike music, N-D, let's chat. But oh, nice
more
music.
Music.
More music
and
less
chat
on
good
session.
No.
No. You tuned into the wrong one,
you
mister.
You got the wrong station there, boss.
Tune into KNLLB
XYZ. Is there anybody there?
Is there anybody out there? That's the name of the song.
Hello, is there anybody there?
Yeah, that was by Pink Floyd. Jerry, you're a country music fan.
Yeah, what's that yoke there?
More music and less chat,
no,
but good station.
What's that yoke there, yeah.
Yeah, it's the same message that came up there.
Okay, you're in.
By somebody.
Hi, sis. Oh, she's gone, darling.
More music and less chat.
Oh, God, there I am repeating myself. I hate this Irish language kind of watch accent.
I'll watch it there as well.
Hi, sis.
Mm. What's that? Joe O'Brien, Anthony Heaney have joined. Of course I have. Where else would I be? More would you go away, would you? And to my beautiful fans out there who are stalking me, I am giving away t-shirts if you'd like one. It'll be signed by myself. It'll cost you €25. Apologies for the beard and the thing. I'm kind of going for the piratey look tonight. Now,
I'm sorry, you're going to give them €25?
No.
Just
to
take?
No, I'm just going to hit them all out with it overall. Deadly weapon, that is, you know.
Trouble the roads are very nice.
They're nice enough. You know you can buy them in bags now, they're kind of loose.
Yes.
They're lovely, I suppose. Is there any...
No, I haven't tried them yet.
They're lovely.
I was only with...
Pink Floyd.
Is that Pink Floyd playing now?
No, that is the Go-Go's and Our Lips Are Sealed, and that is from Michael down in Bagnestown. There you go, Michael! I hope that wasn't anything in reference to me keeping my mouth shut, because I don't think that's going to happen tonight. I'm in that kind of mood that I'm going to be slagging people off tonight, and I'm going to be making another fool of myself, which is what they all seem to like be doing. I used to have a show called Electric Dreams here on Wednesdays. It turned into slightly dull nightmares, or something like that.
Ha!
What? It changed into something. Do you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to share this.
Christine Kelly's in.
Christine Kelly, how
no,
are
Christian
you?
Christian Kelly.
Oh, Christian, sorry. Am I getting the girls mixed up with the boys
it's
again?
It's not girls, it's a boy.
It's a boy. Oh, sorry.
In Limerick.
Wait, really?
Oh, yes.
Ah.
A fellow DJ.
All right. Hello, Limerick.
In Limerick.
No references now to anything bad down there, because it's my hometown, and I will, of course, hit you with Toblerone, which, by the way, is part of me, by the way. T-O-N. There you go. Now, Anne-Marie Leary has... Hello, Tinkerbell. She's blown a kiss, but we don't know who she's blown a kiss at.
Me.
Is it yourself? There you go. You've blown it. Oh, God, I've ever hit my bike. She's after hitting the mic. Now, if there's anything you'd like to talk about or anybody you'd like me to roast, I'm more than happy to do that. The next song that we have up is Don't Be Cruel. Unfortunately, I can't help you there, because tonight's going to be nothing but cruelty, isn't it? Absolute cruelty.
What's that?
I don't know. I'm just making it up as I go along. Hey, no, that's Presley.
Yeah, of course it is.
Okay, there you go. Don't be cruel. I don't think...
It's probably not. It's probably the Stray Cats.
It's actually played by the Cheap Trick artists.
Same thing.
If you didn't know it, we have a connection up here to Elvis Presley and... Walt Disney. They both had ancestral claims to Carlo. They're both buried here as well.
The what?
They're both. What? I don't know. I forgot.
Some meatloaf for Rod Stewart.
Evening, lads, says Kirsten Kelly. Yeah, we can get a bit of meatloaf. Or we go to get some meat Stewart or Rod loaf. We'll do that.
Bye, lads. Lisa's gone for the aerobics.
Lisa, have a great time. Make sure to do the doggy paddles. No doggy tie style now, okay? Just doggy paddles.
We're here till 11, Lisa.
Are we?
I am.
You are. I'm going to go home and cry in my pillow.
I'm with you at 11 o'clock. No, I'm not. I'm with
there
you at 9 o'clock.
Till 11 o'clock.
Don't be cruel. Don't be cruel.
I'm alive.
You're telling everybody you're alive.
Yeah.
That's
and I'm being
live or alive.
I am live and I don't know what I'm doing.
Well, that's like the rest of it. So we're making up as we go along.
There we go.
Well, we're making a good fist of it, as the man says.
On Carol.
One of these days we'll get rid of that from that.
What?
Yeah, so
get rid of what? What?
There's the orbit sitting there for the last 4 months.
This thing?
No.
And it's in the way of it.
This thing?
No.
That's the urn. that's the previous DJ.
We got rid of him.
This is Bob. Bob was very naughty. We burnt him to a crisp. What's in the way? This thing?
No.
No.
It was over here.
There's nothing in the way. It was over there.
What is?
Oh, right! I accidentally knocked it off the window.
What's in there?
There's a... That's Bob.
Oh, that's Bob.
That's Bob. That's Bob. Hello, Bob.
Yeah.
Goodbye, Lisa. Make sure to get your little water rings on so you don't. And remember,
come back when you're finished.
Come back when you're finished. Remember,
see you in an hour.
Remember, it's a doggy paddle, not doggy style.
Leave the.
Oh. Okay, we need to do something about this. I need to be more concentrating on my beautiful listeners out there because, you know, I'm very popular on radio. Now. I've been post already three times.
What happened to the biscuits?
I didn't have one. Now
I got the bus. I got the bus.
You got the bus.
I got the bus.
Do you remember
you
the Kimberley Spring
for one, and then all of a sudden two or three of them arrived.
Do you remember the
time?
Ad that used to say Spring Sprung? It says Spring Sprung biscuit. Remember that?
No.
Used to be on RTE.
No, we're not old enough.
When there was only
RTE. I didn't say it.
No, but you were thinking.
When there was only RTE.
Yeah. Well, we're not old enough to remember that either.
And it used to be like that, look. It says Spring Sprung. It used to squeeze down like that.
I don't remember.
You're doing it to the wrong camera. You want that camera over there.
Oh, sorry.
Don't do a camera two. Do a
camera one.
We're using
is that got a camera?
We're using two cameras.
Is that camera on?
No.
You should run off on that one as well. Although, then again, you confuse people, wouldn't you?
Yeah, you would.
You know, and people are easily confused.
So anyway.
Thank you.
So basically speaking, that goes squeeze. And it goes oozing out with other things.
Mm.
If you squeeze it.
Declan Spring has joined us. Hello, Declan. Welcome to the Manic Wednesdays.
And then you can lick it.
It's very. There's a lot of innuendos in here tonight.
Sexual innuendos, yeah.
No, I never.
Behind the majority of it.
I am absolutely not behind the majority of it. I said there's a lot of innuendos.
In your end. No. Is your dyslexia kicking in again?
What?
Is your dyslexia kicking in again?
Something's kicking, I don't know what it is. Oh, God, help me. I'm sharing myself all over the internet. See, you're thinking it. I said something innocent.
Don't even go there. Anyway, why are you saying that to you?
You don't
forget, lads, I am with you at 9 o'clock tonight for Carlo Country. Here on Carlo FM 88.1, which we haven't mentioned yet,
www.carlofm.com. Stop you right there.
We've also been sponsored tonight by Toblerone. And other sweeties are available.
I have proof here now that
I'm still waiting for the cakes.
I have proof that I've said it three times.
They're cakes Monday.
Bet you squeeze a lot of...
Come here. Listen. Tinkerbell.
Behave yourself.
No,
Lily.
It's not. But I'll tell you one thing, Lily.
What's that? I've got Lily.
Wouldn't mind doing that now, squeezing it.
Oh.
You, Ross. Didn't ask me, did you? And all the info I got.
Oh my God. Do you know what?
In tears laughing.
I've got a lovely song here and I'm going to dedicate it here now. It's Jerry Hagler.
Here now.
And this one is from Jerry.
The limerick accent coming out again, though.
This is Jerry Halliwell, and the name of the song is Ride It.
Yeah,
I don't know.
You seriously need to talk to someone, you don't ask.
I do.
Right.
What was the name of the song?
Ride on. Oh, me do. I've half a yolk to squeeze.
Poor Lily has. Oh, sorry, Lil. You're not supposed to hear that.
You won't.
Who actually sang that one then? Cure? No, not Cure.
Right on.
Yeah.
No, it was a woman.
No,
it wasn't.
Your man.
Your man
for Kildare. Yeah. Don't forget your shopping if you want to
go to work.
That fella.
Where is that now? Hold on, I know that song.
Christy Moore.
Christy Moore!
Yes! It was a Christy Moore, wasn't
was it?
Yeah. Yeah, it was.
And I'm not telling you it was Christy Moore.
There you are. I don't know why you're looking for more numbers, because you're not going to get half the ones.
You're not even going to get half of what you have up there, please.
I know. No, I'm looking for shovel.
Are you looking for a shovel if you want to go to war?
There you go, Christy Moore. Don't
I'll look, put her up there now. We'll have her up there.
We'll have her there, and we're going to let her run through.
You should just pick five songs to do this
show. Yeah, yeah, that's
I
about it.
I should too.
What every 15 minutes is there at all?
The first hour of the show will be based on innuendos, and the second half of the show will be in your outros. Oh, in your outro.
Yes. Anyway,
we got the new driver's license today.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Except for the airplane.
Yeah.
All aboard! Hello to Jason Bradshaw. Jason, how are you doing, Jason? Welcome to the Wednesday night. We've forgotten what we call the show.
Wednesday Night Mayhem.
There we go, Wednesday Mayhem or something like that. Anyway, it used to be the Electric Dreams, it's now the Electric Nightmares. And if anybody.
Stay in that mode.
Now, if you remember what I was saying...
Don't show the address, please.
The 1 millionth and one customer will win a free driver's license.
They'll give them away, Carl.
I tell you what, if I was a police officer and I said, do you have insurance, please? Arrest him! You do know you got that for 10 years. You should have shaved. So they wouldn't recognise you.
I found out there's actually no charge to change address or anything like that.
Is there not?
No.
There you go. Now.
So if you're worried about that and your moved house.
Bernie says, sorry, I have to go. My daughter here visiting me.
Hello, Caitlin, how are you?
But you joined in, Caitlin.
Hello.
So what do you want to be talking to
Can I ask a serious question?
Talk to tomorrow.
Was I being too naughty? Yeah. Is it me? Is that why you're leaving?
Yeah.
Or was I too naughty?
No, it's your daughter's arrived.
No, it's because I was too naughty.
Naughty?
Hold on. I was too naughty.
Naughty?
Naughty.
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 What's
naughty?
Hold on. I
got tea. Naughty. I'm rescuing these biscuits over here.
Oh, I thought you said you didn't have any.
I didn't have any at all. I'm just rescuing these four.
What's your song?
It's okay, because the reason I got that is because of this. The next song coming up here is Computer Games, and it's My Sex.
That's amazing.
Hold on, I'll wait for it here because we've got a delay.
What did I miss?
I'm waiting for it. Here, look, Jerry, you'll see it here. There's a few seconds of a delay now.
That's from Lily.
What was it? No, it's going to come up here. We'll see it in the video image. Come on!
When you said you had something to squeeze,
she
went,
oh,
here we go!
There we go! Slap on that head!
She
didn't hear me.
No! We're not opening the Toblerone, we're only looking at it.
The freezer.
We're not lying, Nilly. Andy Heaney.
And I'm all here. In spirit, but not in body. Or is that the other way around, is it? I'm in body, but not in spirit.
Probably a bit of both.
Oh, lads.
I probably should put that more up here, shouldn't I? Hello to Michelle Brown, hello and welcome and thank you for joining us here on radio. We don't know what we're doing, we never know what we're doing.
No, we're making it up as we go along.
We literally make it up as we do on 3FM.
Would you like to ask Michelle Michelle, where's she from?
Limerick. Now, how did I know that?
Probably related to you.
We are, she's my cousin. Hello, Michelle, how are you? Excuse the 10 o'clock shadow.
What's a 10 o'clock shadow?
It's 2 5 o'clock shadows on both sides of the face.
He's at it again.
There's actually a... What?
He's at it again.
What?
It's what?
What's a 10 o'clock shadow?
There's 2 5 o'clock shadows on that side of the face.
See, what's really concerning is you get the joke, yeah, that I said, and I don't even get it.
Lee is on.
Hello, Lee. How are you? It's Lee, L double E, not Leah, as in Princess Leah.
Am I right? Far from a princess, I bet.
Hello, Lee.
Anne Marie says, hi, Anthony. Honey, and sexy. Who's sexy tonight, me or you?
Sexy looking tonight.
No.
She's always sexy looking.
Lily, put on your glasses.
Lily was always sexy looking.
I think she's talking about me.
Lily, put on your glasses.
I fancy something squeezable.
Remind us about the who was it that had their dog at their glasses?
She's not on there yet.
There we go. Computer Games by MySex. And of course before that we had
by what?
MySex. MySex is the name of the band.
Is my what?
MySex.
Why's your sex?
Ah, feck off, would you? Feck off.
Amory says bought and looking for something squeezy. That's squeezy. There you are, look.
That's stereo. Can I borrow that?
I'll tell you one thing.
Hold on, that's squeezy.
You can't do that, we'll be taking off from there.
Well, I'll take him. There we go. Oh. There you go. No.
I have a marshmallow in the coffee.
I might have just invented something really nice.
Ah, Jesus. That's cool.
Well, Costa.
No, it's too funny. It's too funny. I can't.
Listen, Damien, do not call 999, yeah? Call Costa instead.
Show up. He's put a marshmallow in me coffee. Something squeezy and hot. I have to suck that now.
Is there anything I can give
you? You can squeeze me anytime. And says, Lily, come here. Yes. What's that?
It's a scooper.
It's a super scooper.
Hold on, let me invent something. Hold on a second. Hold on. We'll get the pencil. We'll invent
something. Take that out there with you. Here.
Oof. The thing just fell off my hands.
That's it.
I don't know. Oh, look, he's still in the room with us, even though he isn't there. There you go. This is a specially designed thingy. No?
That's a specially designed thingy. It's called a bloody spoon.
Ease it, it might be nice. There you go, how would that taste? How would that taste? Nice? Jerry, you can squeeze my any time. There you go, Jerry. You've just got the offer from Tinkerbell. You can squeeze her question marks any time.
Not a bother.
Here, show us your hands. Hold on, put your hand next to mine. Yeah, I think they're right size.
As Tinkerbell will tell you anything more than a handful is a waste. Anyway, then, Mike. Sorry.
Right. Before
we're gone.
Oh, God. You know, I've looked at my playlist.
No, come here. Never mind the playlist.
Can I just say something before you do that? I've looked at my playlist, right? One that I chose back in March. For some reason, I didn't put June in, so I'm going by March's music. Everything is love. When I'm gone, I will love you. Don't forget me. Love. I must have been in a strange humour on March to have all these love songs in there.
It's a wonder you didn't have them in February in the middle of it.
I know.
For Valentine's Day.
I know. Some people don't deserve Valentine's Day. No, there you go.
Anyway. Since last week, Councillor Healy. Yes. I think what we got last week.
No. Thank you. Right, we have a community update coming in here for everybody who's in Carlow Town. Just to let you know that Tullow Street will be off limits from 8 p.m. until 6 a.m. until let's see, June the 18th until September the 2nd or 3rd or thereabouts. Irish Water have decided to come in and dig up the entire upper hand part of Tullis Street. They're going to lay down new pipes, and once they've done that, they're going to put a new surface down. Once the surface has gone down, Carlow County Council will be coming in to dig that surface back up and put down another surface down on top of that. So if you're driving through town at night time, please avoid Upper Tullis Street. Try take the Kennedy Avenue version, or if you're going towards Dublin, head towards Limerick instead. Now, next up...
Just take the ring road.
Just take the ring road. No. You take the high road.
I take the ring road.
Right, I'm going to be playing another song, and it's Don't Get Me Wrong by the...
Pretenders.
There we go.
I got one right.
But hey! Oh, dear God.
Sharing
yeah, sharing with everyone and anyone. I've even shared on the Limerick page as well.
Get me wrong.
Did you share it on the Parallel FM page?
Oh yeah.
Perfect. And I will share it in these lads. Who we want on
yeah.
Yeah.
Can we share it the other one?
Which one?
The one without the sea.
The one at the sea?
You can't do it.
You've been tempting. Oh my God! What's this about? I've been restricted from sharing.
Oh yeah.
Oh my. Let us know until Saturday.
What?
I've been, look at this. Action blocked. You have been restricted from joining or posting in any groups you do not manage until Saturday, 5:45. Right. What day is today?
That's from Lily.
Today's Wednesday, I've now been restricted.
Where is from Lily?
I was told to give you a slap in the head from Lily.
Hello, John Holy, welcome.
You can squeeze my. Did you see what she said?
Yeah. They can squeeze them any time. Now here's a question now. Is it me? It must be me because I'm logged in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, let me try this. Let me actually log in as myself. There's an identity crisis coming up here now. Watch this. Now, shower.
Yeah, but hang on now, you're sharing.
I was sharing only 3 times. Even that.
You should share about 20 times today.
I know, yeah, Facebook doesn't like me because I'm more popular and I invented Facebook before they did. Right, okay.
Don't
you
view back?
Now, hold, wait for it. It's me!
It's
not you or you! It's me! Fucking really? Facebook! They can go and flip off now. Remember that? Go jump in the dry lake.
They don't like
you. They don't like
me. Go take a long walk off the shop here.
Yeah. Now, I invented Facebook, did you know that? In
John Howe.
2001.
Evening, lads. You're looking well. Thanks, John.
Thank you, John. I'm looking not too
well
bad.
Done.
John.
Thanks, John.
Well, we're talking about innuendos tonight, you know, and they're coming hard and fast. Oh!
I did, yeah. Yeah, I know what you said, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
They're bringing the sexual innuendos back into it again. This is really... This show has really...
Gone downhill.
Oh, by the way, lads, just to remember... No, I'll do it when we're on air to everybody.
Okay. Oh! Another one! He's going to do to everybody on air. What you do in your personal time is none of our business.
You keep that between you and Lily.
There you go, Lily. Lily, if you're not doing anything on the weekends, you want to maybe, you know... Meet up with
Mary. She won't be doing something the weekend. Probably not with me, but she will be doing something the weekend. I can assure you. Oh, yeah.
And we're alive. There we go. Yes, we are. Don't Get Me Wrong by the Pretenders.
What was I going to say?
And
I
the
don't
number
know.
Is 085 167 6738. You can catch us.
How many times you have to look at that now to read it out once?
Yeah, I did, yeah.
Twice, you had to look at it twice. What, to read
you know, my excuse is I was looking at the people over here and
you
I was going,
liar.
Yeah.
Liar,
pants on fire.
Yeah, anyway.
Carol FM, go on, you want to say something, Jerry?
John, how evening, lads, and you're looking well. Thanks very much, John. Good evening to you. etc., etc. I have it up there as well.
There you go. Okay. Good. There's a good use now for a Toblerone. It'd be good for other things, but it's not the right shape.
Yeah, I know, but I mean... anyway!
It's like, hold on!
You behave yourself.
Listen to me. If you ever see those tests, you have a child, you try to get the triangle hole, the round one into the round hole.
Put a triangle into a round hole.
It doesn't go in!
Goes in my gob. And that's round.
Anyway,
shut up. Just to remind you... Can I just say something? That I am on at 9 o'clock with Carlo Country here on Carlo FM 88.1.
The featured
dish of the day today will be...
Sure.
Oh, it'll be apple tart.
Apple pie.
Oh, lovely. Do you know, can I
not
just...
Not you want apple
can
pie.
Can I just say something to you? I did something...
It's called apple tart. In America, it's called apple pie.
I did something very bad yesterday, lads.
Go on.
I went to...
Too much American in...
I went to Rats and I bought two...
Other shops are available.
And I bought the creamiest buns. You know the eclair one? It's got the chocolate. Yeah. And I bought the donut, long donut one. It had sprinkles all over it and everything. I went home myself and I ate the two of them.
You greedy...
No.
Yeah, I ate two of them.
Who's coming in?
Eamon Howlett likes the It's Carlo, It's All About Carlo FM. Hello! I'm live on It's All About Carlo FM, apparently. It's all about Carlo FM.
Yeah, can I put it on?
Well, did you not get it? It's all about Carlo FM. Don't you go stealing that! Don't you go stealing that!
Where's my phone?
I've just got a bit of a worry. What? A certain person somewhere up in Dublin was acknowledging the Toblerone.
Other streets are available.
Yeah, and other
streets.
Triangle. Right? And they were acknowledging it, remember?
Hmm.
Do you think they might acknowledge the innuendos as well this week?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Mm-hmm.
Not after what a certain other radio station did, but that was in praise of it.
Mm. Yeah, that's what I'm worried about. They're going to do innuendos this time. How does she go? Hello there, I'm Nani, and I'm from Dublin. No? Who's laughing? Anyhow. Nobody's laughing. Do you know what I'm going to do?
Moving along.
No. Listen to me. I want to give the two of you a belt and a shovel in a second.
Right,
and do you know who's going to help me?
Yes.
Christy Moore.
Yes.
Go on.
And we're going to do it.
We're going to do it.
Down man from Kildare. Go on then.
Go on.
Don't forget your shovel. If you want to go to work. Hey, don't forget your shovel.
Let's go louder this one. Are you the part you came from like the rest of us? That's 60 if you do. Open the door. Bang up your shoes, don't strip down your arm. We got a live session coming on here. Sing if you know the words. Don't forget your shoes, don't strip down your arm. Mr. Murphy's a grudge and make it clear. If you take a ball along.
Sing if you know the words. And if you want to do it, don't you do it against the wall. We do. If you want to do it, don't you do it against the wall. If you don't in the ends of the wall. And the wall. Shut up in the corner, but I don't want to see you alive. And the wall. And the wall. And your sandwiches. How to leave it all. In the power, give us a job to begin a web to run the sky.
I don't know.
Oh, don't forget to shovel if you want to go to work. Dino! Are you in the part you came from like the rest of us? So, dig in. Tell me your plan, Paul.
Dig it.
No, I don't want to dig it.
Oh, we're gone, we're done, we're over. I actually do hate songs like that at the end. I love the songs, but I hate it when they end like that.
He's opened the toll.
Do you know what? I'm going to have to give you a new name, Jerry.
Trouble the Road.
No. I'm going to find the name of the person that you've just reminded me of. And before we do that, we're just going to...
Hang on now, who the hell ever reminded you of?
I'm going to find his name out and I'll let you know. And until then, it's a crazy thing called...
Love.
Love.
Hey.
1 second now.
Patrick Proctor is joining us.
Hey, Patrick!
Hello,
Paddy!
All the way from
Patrick.
What's wrong, Paddy?
His name is Patrick. Oh, sorry, Patrick!
Wonderful.
Oh,
decent radio station.
Oh, no, Patrick. Patrick's going to start out with Patrick. All the way from Waterford. Patrick, by the way, don't forget to pick me up tomorrow evening.
Turn it up for a week. How many more pages have you on that open?
Yeah, you're going to crash that. I didn't open any pages.
Well,
look,
close them down.
Right.
The ones we don't.
Searching for phone sex is there.
Close it. Close it.
Right.
Close the next one.
Let's bring her back up again.
Leave that one open.
Put that back where it was. Would you go away, Mr. Assbook?
And then when you're finished, with it, make sure you log yourself out.
So I log myself out of here.
When you're finished to see.
No, I have a better idea. I lock myself in as you, and then I can share it wherever the hell I want.
No, you want? Yeah, get me locked.
You
won't end up getting me blocked off.
Yeah. I'm after sacrificing myself for this station.
Will you lock me in?
I'll pass. Do you know what I was eating one the other day? My hands were all chocolatey, right? And I was right in front of Emma, and she said, "What are you doing with your hands?" I'm rubbing them to get all the lovely chocolate off.
Yeah, and then he realised what he was saying.
Yeah.
I have to say, she is an absolute lovely
girl.
Isn't
she?
Yeah.
I haven't seen her since before I saw her. She's got to come into a crazy winter with us.
No, she's in tomorrow night.
Are you going to do a crazy
No, she's in with Nicole tomorrow
Nicole,
night.
Oh, there you go. Perfect. What's your password? Oh, I know what it is. Oh, what a back. I got it just in time. Yeah. Now, if you're all listening out there, we're all going to give you Damien's password. If you've got a pen and a paper, please write it down.
Hang on for a second, though.
The following password is A.
B.
B. /C. X. Y. 1852. So you can all log into the Facebook now. You can all go live with us. Righto.
Should we,
Listen.
There you go.
Right, I have something. You got two messages there, Damien.
Oh, it's okay.
Oh.
I know what they are.
You got two messages. You're in trouble there now.
Don't turn that up.
I didn't do that on purpose. I didn't do that on purpose.
Go your lines.
I wanted to do this.
Text Carol FM on 085-167-6738. We play your music your way 24/7.
Now, see, somebody says I don't mention the number. Not only do I mention the number, I have it on the promo.
Andy, read that.
Can you go back
on your
own page?
And don't give anything.
This
like
one
that.
Here.
Just read that pause.
This one here. I cannot believe someone has nicked my mother's and father's old cooker from our garden and is selling it on Facebook for £149. Should that be yours?
Your expert shop.
So it's
Snackers. Are ye faithful?
Who really?
Said that one? Lily.
Oh
Lily,
my
I will
God.
Give you a slap with
Lily.
A
Lily.
I will.
Lily.
Me?
Lily.
Huh.
Now, where were we? Carol FM. So yeah, listen to this, folks. Hold on a second.
You can't.
No.
No.
He's fucked up.
I cannot believe someone has nicked my mum and dad's old cooker from our garden and is selling it on Facebook for €149. Even though it's knackered. There are some weird people out there, folks. They're absolute scrubbers. Scrubbers! Right, now, do you know what we need?
Talking about scrubbers, Brillo pads were great.
Oh, they were.
Other scrubbers are available.
Other scrubbers are available.
Other scrubbers are.
Can we go? Are you on Carl O'Liven? Did you
No. That, see, the camera's up there.
I know it is.
See, look. Here.
Anne-Marie O'Leary said.
Hold on. Oh, you have to. I did nothing. Right, can you name the movie? Right, I'm going to do it one way, right? Name the movie.
It's got two letters.
E.T.
Yes. Hey, there we go.
It's not BT, not E.T. It's BT.
BT. I thought they merged with someone.
Anne-Marie O'Leary would like to hear an Xmas song. Called.
What's an Xmas song?
Same thing as Christmas song.
Is it?
She'd like to hear.
We've done an absolute mess of it. Yeah. What I can't find.
She would actually wants to hear. Oh, come.
All ye faithful.
As in.
Bad reception, folks, from somebody on
085-662-8592.
Bad reception where?
Can you do me a favour? Can you tell me what network you're going and we can give you the phone number for them?
Where?
Now, next up we have. Okay, can I just say this? This one goes out to Lily.
Right, go on.
Okay? This song is for Lily. And it's by an artist called Quiet Riot.
One thing that Lily is not.
Wait till you hear the name of the song. Come on, feel the noise. Look at that bloody thing right there. I didn't write this. There you go, Lily. That one's for you.
Mike.
Never took it off your face.
Turn down,
but you're very upfront now.
Hold on. Turn that face.
Turn down.
They never take me off. Turn that face.
Because we're going down, you see, now. Coming off your
face. No, sit on my face.
Yeah. Alright.
Yeah, sit on that.
Okay. Sorry, no, who's that?
Should we start in the
front? Yeah.
Those numbers, don't go by those numbers. Those only people that are actually part of the group. Those are the people that are actually not part of the group, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
You've got a section of people that are in all the groups who share it. If they watch, they come up on that.
Yeah.
And then you got people who are not part of a group who will watch anyway.
How do you know that?
I checked it online. And the other way I did as well is, I don't have to go into the video to watch it. Right? I can go to the webpage, and I can still watch it like that. Yeah. If I cut this song, this one here, is it? Hold on, cut down here. Okay. Right, cut that sound for a second. We're going to do a technical jargon here, folks. Now, I've gone into Caro FM Live, right, and I just click on that. Now, you don't know I'm watching it because I've not gone into the comment section.
All right.
That's the thing about Facebook. If there's tricks and ways or whatever, I don't know. But I'm logged in there now. You probably won't see me unless I go in and put a comment in or something. Oh, look, there I am talking. Right, let's test. And then I go. Actually, Damien is actually, that's you.
Yeah.
There we go. And I'll probably see you've joined in or something. And then we mute you. And
Damien Proctor, test two.
Ah, look, it doesn't matter because we're going in. Oh, has Aaron, did Aaron look for that other thing that I'm seeing?
Is that the same person that
time? Yeah.
Yeah. Good thing.
No, I live in private best.
What? Ooh. Oh, there we are. Perfect. Found it. Okay.
Let me see what the story is.
Why is there bubbles in the room? Come Feel the Noise, and that was the artist Quiet Riot. That one goes out to Tinkerbell, who's all the way out there in old No Man's Land.
New Ross.
Oh, that is No Man's Land. What was that?
I don't know.
We're getting all kinds of strange noises in here.
There's
tonight.
There's something online.
Come Feel the Noise, and that was the artist. Somehow that's me. I am talking to myself.
Yes, you are talking to yourself. Would you ever turn down the vocal, please?
They're turning down the vocal now, folks. Now, there we go. So, our community message will be coming up in a few moments. I was just going to do a few promos, and we'll be back right after that with a little bit of Peter Berkley and Crying in That Chapel. Stay tuned, folks. You know the station is Caro FM, 88.1 FM.
We play your music your way 24/7.
You're listening to Caro FM.
You're listening.
On 88.1. And online at www.carolfm.com.
You should change it to a sound that goes pudding. Hey, I'm just saying that, you know. Okay. Yeah.
Whatever that means.
Yeah. Pudding. Do you ever just sound pudding? Pudding. Oh, that's a lovely thing. Hello to Beverly Carberry. How are you doing, Beverly? Thank you very much for the comment. Beverly says, this is a great site from which we could all get together and voice our opinions about anything that might be happening in Carlo or about to happen. It's a great discussion forum that doesn't quite require endless meetings as in the past. Let us all embrace it as a forum for public interchange on issues that matter on the subject. There we go. Thank you very much for that, Beverly. And hello to Betty Ryan O'Gorman as well, who says, correct and up to the point, Bev. Who else can we say hello to? Who? Would you go away with the bubbles? Or I tell you, I will murderise someone tonight. Now, we have a community update, which we will be doing in a couple of minutes live on 88.1 FM. So stay tuned for that. This will, of course, be relevant to those living in the Carlow Town area, if you're listening. Oh, that's just a random rod. I'll actually tell you something up here in a while. I was very disappointed. That's something. Actually, there won't be anything up here. I'll message you, actually. It'll be better that way. Heaney has just logged in. Hello guys. Let's actually come back with us. It's Jerry is sending them bubbles to me. Oh, Jerry.
Oh.
I can send you better bubbles.
Leave the dirt out of it.
Hold on. Quantity over quality.
No.
And we're back. That is Crying in the Chapel by Peter Berkley. Coming up now, we have a community update for those in Carlow Town. Starting on the 18th of June, Tullow Strait Upper will be closed for much needed repairs. In the first phase, Irish Water will be carrying out these repairs to upgrade the existing pipe work.
The closure of Tullow Street, it's understood, will be at night time to avoid any unnecessary knock-on effects to local businesses in the area, and so this work will be done throughout the night. If you were driving in around, or if any business in around town after 8 o'clock, we would advise that you take Kennedy Avenue
that
or
is
Dublin.
On my page.
Shh. Kennedy Avenue or Dublin Street if you wish to make your way in or around the town centre. The closures will come into effect as and from the following dates. Phase 1, Potato Market to College Street, will begin on Monday the 18th of June to Sunday the 1st of July 2018. On Phase 2, College Street to Cathedral close from Tuesday the 2nd of July to Sunday the 15th of July 2018. And on Phase 3, Cathedral close to 57 to 91 Tullow Street from Wednesday the 11th to to August the 12th, 2018. In and around Carlow itself, there are plenty of other roadworks going on that you may wish to avoid. Carlow County Council have, as you've probably noticed, have begun resurfacing many of the roads, especially the Wexford Road out by the Dunn Stores at Talbot Hotel. Other stores and hotels are, of course, available.
And then straight to go on to dig them back up.
Probably. Carlow County Council wishes to advise the surface dressings works will be carried out on the L3052. Damien, could you please pronounce this, please? Tinderland?
Tinder Island.
Thank you very much. Tinder Island Village.
Tinder
Island Village.
That's it.
Hold on. Tinder Island Village to the motorway overpass by Ballyloo Road
on
Tuesday,
yeah,
the 12th of June until 6 p.m. approximately. The road in question will be closed and diversions will also be in place. Drivers are advised to avoid the area in question if it is at all possible. Carlow County Council wishes to apologise for any inconvenience this may cause to members of the public who reside or normally use the area in question, and will endeavour to have the works completed by the appointed time. There we go.
Well,
that's your...
If it's Carlow County Council, well, the local authority, they won't, because they'll come back next week and they'll dig them all up again. As they normally do.
As they normally do. Now, there we go. Right, coming up after this, we're going to have...
That reminds me, too, we were supposed to have an individual from the council come in and talk to us about this new plan, this planned upheaval of Carlow County.
Oh, it went to the other one. It went to the other one.
They?
Yeah.
Talk about two-faced.
Yeah.
For what?
For the new town plans. It
yeah.
went to the other station. Carlow FM is here, we're live there now, and we're on Carlow FM live on Facebook. We're on 88.1 FM,
as
and number is...
As the man says, we'll remember that.
085-167-673, it's our number if you want to give us a message. You can also get us live on Carlow FM live. We're live through the various Facebook pages, so no matter where you go in Carlow, you're going to find us, whether it's on the Carlow Facebook page, if you go, it's all about Carlow, Carlow FM, you'll find us everywhere. And we're also, as I said, live on 88.1 FM. Now, we've got a sound coming in from Mary in Tullow, believe it or not. She says she's kind of getting it out there, it's a little trashy, but she's getting it perfectly fine out there. And she's asked for Glass Tiger and Don't Forget Me When I'm Gone. Well, we certainly won't forget you, don't worry about that, here on Carlow FM.
Did you manage to get a few songs played tonight?
I did. I don't think there's anybody watching, but listen.
Oh God.
We got the roof.
Yeah.
They're vastly getting on the wrong side of me, and if you get on the wrong side of me, they will regret.
I don't mind.
Yeah.
Now, sorry, it was a bit of technical information. Now,
technical difficulties.
Now, if you are in the Carlo area, you've probably heard of my old page. It's all about Carlo. We're promoting Carlo and have been for the last 2 or 3 years now. There's a new page coming to Carlo, a new group coming to Carlo very shortly. I'm not going to name what it is at the moment. It's something quite exciting, and there will be a documentary every night at 8 o'clock. That's what I will say. There will be a lot of information, amazing photos of the day, and if you'd like to maybe join that particular group, just head over to It's All About Carlo, check it out. You'll see the link is in there. If you want to do it, just add me as a friend, or just go into the post if you want to join the group.
Tony
Quinn join, hello. And if you want to do join, just let me know, I'm more than happy. It will be launching on the 1st of July. Everything is nearly set up for it. So you know what to do. Go to It's All About Carlo and you can join up there. The page will open on the 1st of July. Now, who...
Provided you're not blocked.
Provided you're not blocked, yes. Exactly. Now...
Okay, I'm going to swing for Samsung.
Samsung?
Samsung. Other phones are available.
They've updated their firmware on it, and it's actually destroyed everything. It's actually... You clearly can't shut an app down anymore. It stays there in the background.
Yeah. Now, there is other apps that you can download, literally other apps you can download, that will kill them. And you know what I hate is when they put stuff on like Microsoft.
Other.
No, actually the bloody one is. You have an optional update. You can choose yes. That was it.
This is the way it goes. This is the way to go now. Look at. But that's the way to go from now on. Go, right? See, you showing nothing?
Right.
That's the way they're going.
Android settings. Messenger displayed over other. Yeah? Notification set. You can shut the notification set.
Yes, but you don't get. Do you know the way
Hello.
You'd get the
Barack.
The little bubble.
Yeah.
You don't get that anymore. Then when you do that.
Well, I would like to put a message out to Samsung, and to Microsoft, and basically I would just like to say to go.
Leave the systems alone. No. There is an old saying: it's not broken, don't fix it.
So my answer to you guys is F. C-U-K. French Connection UK.
No, F-U-C-K-O-F-F.
There you go now. We're using the fine language tonight here now here on Carlo FM. Anne-Marie O'Leary has joined us after leaving us. She got very upset by all the bubbles that Jerry was sending her.
She got upset that Jerry wasn't giving her any Toblerone.
Oh, that's it.
That could be arranged.
Jerry, can I ask you
other
a question?
Sweets are available.
Other sweets are available.
You know, is she single?
No, we're not going there. Tony Quinn has joined us.
Tony, hello.
Welcome
there.
To the madhouse.
Welcome to the nut house.
All our nuts are available.
Starts at 9 o'clock.
Salted, peppered, and plain.
The dry roast.
Oh God, I can see my bald spot here. This is why I like this.
What?
The covers that you see.
Yeah, what?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I know I was looking for something for you.
Oh, yeah. What was it?
The name of the person that you remind me of. Mm. He's a character on a TV show called Still Open All Hours.
Oh, yeah, I know you're on about.
Ronnie Barker.
No, not him.
Not Ronnie. The yeah, no.
Well, it's not the other fella. It's not David James.
It is Ronnie Barker.
No.
Oh, I think the fella going wearing the dungarees.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
What's his name? What's his name?
Klaus.
No, not Klaus. Klaus, would you go way out of it?
Who's Klaus?
Klaus, my ass. Hey,
who's
not.
Klaus?
Who's Klaus? No,
Klaus was in. It was in. Not Are You Being Served? The other one. LOLO.
Oh, I just finished that. Open All Hours. If you know the name of the character I'm talking about, type it into the Facebook.
Let's see. The new one, not the old one.
Yes, it's called Still Open All Hours.
Christine Kelly's back after he went for his swim and his dinner.
Who? Wait, did he have his dinner before the swim?
No, the Christine Kelly's back. Delivering.
Oh, right. Wait, who? What? Who?
Well, there must have been something on like...
Sorry, that's not touchscreens. Sorry, wrong one.
Not yet, it's not.
That's not even working over there, is it?
Yeah, that's worked.
I don't know.
That's touchscreen.
Go ahead. Anyhow, listen. Do you believe in love?
That depends on what time of the day it is.
Why? What's the difference between 12 o'clock love and 10 o'clock love?
I have no idea.
No, I
don't bother because I don't have Honey, I'm Home.
Honey, I'm Home?
Yeah. Mm. You only walk in the door, Honey, yeah. I'm Home, John. I don't have to say that.
You're so lucky. You are so lucky. As opposed to having come in. Hello? Anyone there? Get your own dinner. It's in the dog. Cook the dog.
I was having a conversation this evening with someone that asked me.
Yeah.
Well, that told me that we remain anonymous.
Right,
right.
It was on a thing called POF.
Right.
Gastric!
Gastric, yeah.
That's his name. It's just, well, you did a little bit of a burp there a while ago, and gastric does it. Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
That's his name.
Oh, that's the name of it, gastric. Right.
Yeah.
Anyway, so I was on, so basically speaking, I heard about this thing called POF.
Mm. POF.
Gone fishing.
It's gone fishing. It's a dating site.
Okay, what's this about?
It's a fishing site.
When you put dates on it, that looks nothing like me.
Yes, it does.
So anyway.
No. Down, turn row down, stop. Second in from the right. Second in, second, dot down, over, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, right.
Fish. Okay, tell me about this plenty of fish.
No, I was only talking to somebody about it.
Okay.
And I just said, they're about dating sites.
Right.
So I said, nah. Wouldn't I bother?
Plenty of fish. Let's have a look at plenty of fish.
Have a look at plenty of fish. Plenty of fish is a dating site.
Plenty of fish Carlo just came up just now.
Yeah, because that's because you're in Carlo.
There we go. So,
it's
plenty
a dating
of fish.
Site. There you are, look.
Oh, she's a fine looking thing, isn't she?
Fine looking horse. Hey, she's down your neck.
What's that about? Oh, yes.
Well,
yes.
That's false anyway. Yeah. There is no way that a woman like that, yeah, with that amount
would be single.
Honor, would be single.
No possible way.
Not a hope in Adam.
You have to join up? Oh, so it's not technically free, so, is
no,
it?
No. You have to join up and do whatever you have to do with it. I had a look at the scene.
What about Dee? She's all right looking, isn't she?
Who?
Dee.
We're not going to start talking about this now.
No.
Nobody else can see it, she said.
Nobody. Go on POF.
Go on POF if you're not on it.
If you're single and you're looking for dates.
And if anybody's got a woman out there that would suit me.
I can't.
No.
Just Warner.
Oh, this is interesting. Plenty of fish chemistry predictor. They've got a thing.
Oh yeah.
It's got a relationship chemistry predictor. It measures five broad dimensions of personality, which are essentially for building a romantic relationship. Okay. And there's currently 37.5 million users. So that means there's 37.5 million people who are single. No, I got that wrong, sorry.
In Ireland.
No, I got this wrong.
In
Carlo. No, I got this wrong. There are 7.5 million people who are single.
And there's
30 million who are not single at all.
No, say that again.
There's
465,905 who are single and the other 37 million aren't.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. That's what dating sites are about these days.
No, well, actually... It's 495,905 genuine users, and the other 37 million are not genuine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There we go.
Okay,
now,
fair enough.
Now, the next song we're going to be playing here on Carlo FM is Huey Lewis and the News. And if you know those guys.
I'm going to play the one Gone Fishing later.
Gone Fishing!
No, the other one is what? No, it's French Kissing. I was going to say French
Letters.
French Fishing in the USA.
Oh, yeah. Have you noticed, and I'm going to cross myself here now. Okay?
Yeah.
I've played a fair few songs.
Yeah.
And I've played them loud. Yeah. And I've not been caught once.
Yeah.
Isn't that strange?
Yeah.
And yes, I have been banned from sharing or joining. That's the longest ban I've ever got.
Really?
Yeah, the most I've got is like a 24-hour ban. And they've not touched me for any music.
What you do is just make up another profile and make it an administrator on all the other pages and then start doing it on that.
Yeah. Now that's something I should mention. Anybody out there with a group or a page, I'd like to give a little mention, a shout out. A
friend of mine has a page, and she's the only administrator on that page, and I was talking to her. Always have a second profile on the Facebook group. Never be a solo, right? If you want to be just by yourself, that's grand, but always make sure to create a second profile. If you lose your first profile, you lose the group.
Yeah.
You can't get back into it. So if you have a second profile on standby, you can log into that, and then you can control it. That's my advice to everybody. Because there was a nasty virus going around there last week, where it got in and it was tagging in with his name. I think Facebook got onto that.
No, I was tagged in it.
Question.
I don't know who I died.
You didn't come up, so you're grand. So. How do you eat your biscuits? I like to do this, pull it out. I like to peel it off. And I like to eat one, two, and three.
That's how I eat my biscuits. I like to put the soft.
I like the other ones. I like what we call the jam rag ones.
Or don't.
There's only you have the cream in the outside. No. And you have the jam in the middle.
Don't.
You squeeze out the jam first with the middle. Don't. You eat the jam first.
Don't.
You know the ones.
Do you know what? My show.
Ricardo.
Yeah.
Kimberly McCardo.
Kimberly McCardo. Other Kimberly's are available.
Other biscuits are available.
Other biggies.
We're getting very bad.
Yeah.
No, actually, do you know what? I think it is late. Only when I come on do you get all the complaints.
Yeah. But it lightens today.
Huh?
It lightens today.
It lightens today.
Yeah. You came in on a downer, now you're smiling.
Well, a true professional knows when to go on there and leave everything right there.
Yeah.
And then go on there and then go
off.
What
are you doing with the biscuit?
Hold on, and then go off and go and murder people afterwards. I'm eating my biscuit, I was just trying to make a point.
Don't forget, the knife is still stuck in the chef outside. Don't forget.
Do you know what? I bet you Jack the Ripper was a famous TV personality before.
He was a... They reckon he was
a
actually
doctor.
A member of
the royal
family.
Family.
Yep.
But do you want to know something even more?
He actually reckons it was Prince Wales.
I know.
Yes,
no, no, can
exactly
I just say, I do know who he was.
Go on.
I actually have his name.
Yeah.
His real name was H.H. Holmes. He was from Chicago. Hold on. I should look, every time I'm talking I get distracted.
Yeah,
now,
I'm
not watching.
No,
now listen, we're coming up to 8:30 and we've
gone
away
from the last half hour of the show. How many songs did you get through tonight?
A fair enough amount, and Facebook didn't block me. Now, we've talked the last 90 minutes about sexual innuendos.
Have we?
Hoo-hoo! In your end! Now, we're going to move on to something
again,
a bit more. Listen, it was you talking about the jam things. Well, don't mention it.
We're not doing anything at all about the roundabout.
Let me finish. We can. In the last 2 minutes.
We can go around that way.
We go around that way. I just wanted to let you know, for the last 100 years, right, people have been trying to figure out who Jack the Ripper was. There's been many accusations, there's many hypotheses and all that kind of talk. Some people were saying the royal family, some people were saying he was a doctor because he was able to surgically cut parts of the person. The fact is, the person, and I'm not joking, I'm serious, the person that actually was Jack the Ripper in England wasn't even English, he was actually American.
That's right, yeah.
His name was H.H. Holmes. And he's the person. And what happened was, they did a history check on this guy and they found he was the first person to invent the murder house. He built a hotel specifically designed to kill his people, or his guests, right? Funny enough, the murders stopped where he was. What's that about? What? Turn around? All right, sorry, you're looking at my bald spot. He turned around. I'm the murderer!
You're doing Bosco on the turn.
You see... Bosco's back again. Look,
Bosco's back again.
Back.
Right.
Where's his jumper?
Hold on a second now. Hold on.
His jumper is there somewhere. There's Bosco.
There he is.
Go on.
What are you going to do?
Go on.
Anyhow.
Oh, Jim.
What are you doing? Way out of it. Watch out. Way out of it. Here, this is how you kill a Bosco. Now, as I was saying... Anyhow, listen to this.
Yeah, go on. H.H. Holmes and his hotel.
So basically, in around the time that the hotel had been discovered to be the murder hotel, and the government had moved in, whatever, the local police constable had moved in, He left the country for about, I think, they say somewhere around 6 months, maybe a little bit more. Yeah. And in that time that he was away, it turned out that in England, identical murders were happening over in England.
In America.
In Whitechapel, in England. I think that's London. And, of course, they all stopped abruptly. And it assumes that because when he stopped the murderers in England, the murderers began again back in America. So the time window between the time of him leaving America and leaving England, all right, is too coincidental.
Yeah.
Too coincidental. Because as soon as he came back to America, the murderers...
7.5 hours on a flight.
A lot more on a boat, like, you know, the slow boat to America. So that's basically what it is. He was the true murderer. Why they haven't put it in is because they can't. They don't have 100% proof, right? It's you. I can't say that you're the one that ate that Toblerone if I didn't see you. Although the proof is all over your face. So there you go. H.H. Holmes is the Jack the Ripper person for you to know. There's your history lesson here on Carlo FM.
Talking about China.
Now, I'll talk about roundabouts.
We're talking about roundabouts.
Go on, talk about roundabouts.
No, well, roundabouts first of all, and then China. What do you reckon to your man?
Can I just stop you there?
Yeah.
That's Korea.
Same thing.
Korea. Kim Jong Un and
Kim Jong Who?
Kim Jong Un.
Who from Nong?
Hey, do you know what's one thing about China?
Right.
Have you ever looked at their form?
Billy Madsen's Titanic.
That was a bit early now for him, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Hold on! Oh my god!
Is that the program?
Listen!
Go on!
Sink it!
Listen!
What?
Jack the Ripper was on the Titanic and he killed all those people and he sunk the Titanic to hide the evidence.
Yeah,
no.
Go on, what are you saying?
I don't know what I was going to say.
Billy Mack put up Titanic. I was wondering, was that the show going down the swan?
No, that's already gone.
See the smile? Yeah, that's a lovely
smile.
Yeah, look at the eyes.
I smile for you.
Now, can anybody tell me what was the name of the United States president that Hitler had met?
Huh?
The who?
Hitler had met and United
Roosevelt.
States... Yes. Now, think about
Roosevelt.
It. Think about it, right?
Theodore.
Right? Roosevelt meets Hitler.
Franklin Theodore Roosevelt, yeah.
Right? And what happens now? We have...
Oh, yes.
Think about it.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, think about that now for a moment.
Short, I think, what was it? About 4 years after, was it? Three or four years after that they had...
So basically speaking,
he's
been...
Now, listen to me.
He's actually made a mess of it.
Now, listen to me. This is a man who's been firing ballistic missiles in the direction of Japan.
Yeah, go on.
And suddenly, right, now he's been saying no to everyone, right? I won't stop, right? He has killed every member of his family, save for maybe two people, right? Mm-hmm. He's assassinated half of his house, okay? He's gotten rid of every single person that has opposed him. His father has, and has only just now come out, has died under strange circumstances, yeah? And all of a sudden, Trump walks over and goes, do me a favour, mate, would you stop throwing all those missiles over towards us? Next thing you know, they're shaking hands.
That.
It's more than money.
Yeah.
It's more than money.
Well, don't forget, hasn't Kim Jong-un accepted an invite to the White House and vice versa?
Yeah.
As well.
Yeah. What I would love to know, right, is that basketball player that went over. What was his name? Remember the big basketball?
Oh, yeah.
He's going over to a guy who is a military dictator, just like in Hitler time.
Yeah.
And he's playing bouncy ball with him.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
I don't know.
He's playing what?
Bouncy ball. He's a basketball player. So if you've got any opinions on this new joint team member.
Who's talking about playing balls?
But did you know
he's a basketball player?
You know, there was what was it, the G8 summit or something in Canada 2 days prior.
Yeah.
And
talking about
Trump,
that G8 summit.
Trump walked out and called Trudeau, the Prime Minister of Canada, waste of space.
Did you see what he did? He shook his hand, and when he took the hand away, the camera zoomed in, and you could see the pressure on Trump's hand. You could see the white part.
You do know a lot of people actually in the States can't stand them, but yet they still voted them in.
Did they though? Did they?
Because they reckon that Russia had a...
Wasn't he a handsome man?
Thank you. Anyway, everybody...
You do know he suffered from dyslexia as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, and after the show, I would be more...
And Roosevelt suffered from... Was it Parkinson's?
Look at this.
KLM... KLM was KFC.
What?
No, sorry. Kim was KFC. Kim
wants KFC.
Ah!
That's what it was, yes.
I knew a guy who worked in a chicken killing factory.
So he wants
KFC.
Who
worked in, was it KFC and McDonald's at the same time?
No. McDonald's
and Burger King.
And Burger King.
Yeah. He went, and he even had the cheek to go into McDonald's wearing his Burger King outfit.
Yeah.
was it to go to work or right, was
hold
it
on,
to,
hold
to
on,
buy
hold on, hold on.
Other fast food outlets right. are available.
Well, not with Colonel Sanders.
Basically, I need a little bit of extra money. There was a job going across
or the clown.
And I was working in both, right? In Burger King, it's a simple matter of getting the burger down, bun down, rubbish down, out. In McDonald's, it was a different way. They had a different setup. A, B, C, D, hexagon, apple, banana, smiley face.
And shite.
And it was all like this. And you had to be doing this at this, you had to do that at that. All the T's were crossed, all the I's were dotted.
Exactly. You do know that technically speaking, you don't have to be able to read and write to work at McDonald's.
Do you?
Yeah.
Good.
Wexford
Rock.
Yeah, they don't know how to, because I went in there and asked for specifically, I said, they got the tail seat and they stuck it to the box.
Yeah, and you're telling me nothing in there with the way
and
you
wipe it. So I politely asked them, do you not require your staff to be able to read and write to work here?
Now, without using any bad stuff about Limerick, I'm going to tell you a story about Limerick and McDonald's. McDonald's have got a new promotion in Limerick and how to get people to join their workforce. It's
Free
called...
Life?
No. It's
Free
called
Shotgun?
No. It's called it's called putting a paper bag with €75,000 in it on a random table.
All right.
It happened in Limerick.
Good.
There was a €75,000 in a paper bag sitting on one of the tables in the restaurant. Imagine that. And some silly fool went over and picked it up and went up to the manager and goes, "Hi, I've after finding some money on the table.
It's yours, you tulip."
I would have gone, "Oh! Bye."
I'll come back for me. I just left my wallet out in the car.
I'll be back next year.
I'll be back in a second for me meal. Yeah. Good luck to you.
You know, I mean, it could have been a sting. It could have been cameras or whatever. Still don't.
Who cares?
I know someone else left his wallet behind today.
Well, who? He did. He always leaves his wallet behind. I'm always convinced you're trying to trick me to steal your money. I got a store in a €20 the other day. I gave it. Actually, Damien,
go on.
If you check, you'll see I'll give you an extra 5 cents in your change.
It's there behind you in the window.
Other coins are available. Right, now, coming up after the...
Well, not twos and ones. Well, actually, come to think of it, the ones and coins.
Even though they're useless.
Yeah, in done stores. Yeah. Do you know the fact?
Not all, folks.
Do you know the quick tills? You know, where the self service tills.
Yeah.
Yeah, I went in there and paid something the other day.
We're talking.
And
I did play This Is Carlo FM to remind people.
Yeah. And put in money anyway, and it gave me back 2 cents, 2 1-cent coins. And it's just, you want? It's just, how they done away with these? No. Well, according to the central bank, they did.
Now, can I just say?
And I just threw them in the bin.
Can I just say? I went to...
another 2 cents of the 5 million gone missing.
I went to a certain...
5 million 1 cent coins in Ireland missing.
I went to a certain supermarket and...
Other supermarkets are available.
They are. And it came up to... The price came up to 4.97, right?
Five of them.
No, 4.97.
And so I went. It reduced down to 4.95.
No, it went up. It went up. No. It went up.
Yeah, but it's supposed to.
I know it is.
Down.
I know it is.
Because it's closer to the 5 than it is to the 1.
So, no change came out. And I said to the lady, what's going on? No change came out. She goes, it rounds up to the nearest whatever. I said, okay, that's fine, grand. Keep the money put in the poor box. But then I thought to myself, out of the 3 cents, how many of that has a shop kept?
Yes.
And do they give that back or do they keep
it? No, they keep the whole lot of it.
So I came back the following week and the same thing happened to me again. So I went up to her and I said, I would like my 3 cents back, please. Oh, I'm sorry, we can't do that. No, I said, I want my 3 cents back.
No, it's 5 cents.
So she went upstairs and came down after 20 minutes and she handed me 3 cents back.
Yes. Technically speaking, they have that. And actually, believe it or not, it should have been 5 cents she should have handed you back, not 3 cents.
Yeah. So my question to all the councillors, the Carlow County councillors, the Dublin County Council, anybody, oh, I know that. But I'm asking you to just answer one simple question for me, okay? Where does the extra change go when it rounds itself off to the nearest decimal point? If it's 5 euros and it's 4.97, where does that 3 cent go? Does that 3 cent go back to the shop? And after about a million customers in a month, that's a lot of money. Where does that money go? That's what I'd like to know.
Think of that. How many customers in a month or 2 months would the big supermarkets have?
So exactly. Now.
So if.
70,000.
So if technically speaking, right, that his 3 cent, right, it was rounded up today. It was rounded up when it should have been actually rounded down. 70,000 multiplied by 3, what? 21,000.
If I go right,
right, 210,000.
0.3, right?
Yeah.
Multiplied, let's say, by 1,000 customers, right? 1,000 customers.
Nor a zero.
Is 30 euros. Now, it doesn't seem much, right? But in that 30 euros, let's say 10,000 euros, that's 300 euros.
Yeah.
But let's suppose they have 100,000 customers, because Fresco are very popular, right? That's 3,000 euros. And multiply that over a 5-year period, you've got 15,000 euros. And that's
per month. So that's per month. Multiply that by 12. Go back, cancel.
Hold on. Right?
Yeah.
Now, this is one store.
Yeah.
They have 70 stores. So multiply that by 70. That's exactly how much money.
12.5 million.
12.5 million.
That's how much money, if you can see that.
Per year.
Right? From every shop, every particular supermarket, taking your 3 cent or your 2 cent, adding it all up over a space of how many? Was it 1 year? Yeah. Over 1 year. So you think about it. Now, if you think that's bad, 3 cent is bad. If you think 3 cent is bad, I can make it even better. €2.50 every single transaction.
Yes.
And I won't name them because you don't want to get sued. But there's
the shops are charging for your...
Yeah. According to certain people, we'll call them certain people A. Certain
items,
people B.
Items to light your house or heat your house.
Yes, so if you're doing your gas, electricity, Virgin Media and other suppliers are available, and your bins, right? And you're paying €2.50, you have to pay that 50 cent for using the card. And as an old age pensioner goes in and they don't have very much money because Radcar needs his new car, they got to pay €2.50. Now imagine that is
they're paying that every month. Hmm. They're paying 50. Well, they pay. Say they get their ESP and gas every week. So that's €1 every week.
So if they're paying
right?
€2,
that's €1 every week. Each individual, right? So like you're talking €52.
But you see, the
year is what each individual is paying.
They're paying the gas.
Yeah.
They're paying the electricity. Yes. Right? We're not talking about internet because some people don't have it, but they do have TV, right?
Yeah.
And they have their bins. That's 4 of them.
That's €4.
Right.
That's €2.
That's minimum because all these pensioners wouldn't have the internet.
Yeah,
you know, to the
some would.
Some would, but not many. Yeah. So
but don't forget, if you have your mobile phone, that's another 50 cent.
There you go.
That's 250.
That's 250. That's one person.
What are you talking about?
Do you know when you...
The charges in the shop for...
Using your card.
Using the card. It's not used. It's actually, believe it or not, it's gone now from using the card. It's not using the card anymore. It's actually for them... To do it on the machine.
Yeah.
The machine that they have is the charge for that machine.
I rang the company and I talked to them and I rang some counsellors and I talked to them and I rang the shops and I talked to them. No wonder I got an email saying, dear Mr. Councillor Heaney.
Yeah.
You know. And the people who own the machine saying that they're not the ones charging. The councillor said that they didn't know anything about it, and the shop said that they have to pay for ink, paper and labour.
They're already paying for the labour.
Oh, and electricity.
And believe it or not, that the machines are supplied to them. So they don't own the machines.
I don't know for 1 second. Are you trying to tell me, out there, that there is no councillor
that doesn't know it?
That basically doesn't go in for any of those four items.
And you even go five with internet.
Five even with internet.
Yeah.
And isn't charged 50 cents.
Apparently they don't know about this.
Well, the other thing, of course, is like, let's break it down for a minute, right? The phone is probably supplied.
Right.
Okay. The internet is probably supplied.
Because they need it for their machines anyway.
Exactly. Yes, they have to have the internet. Machines, yes.
Right. So, ask for their bins from their own county council, they'll probably get them for nothing.
Yeah.
The fourth one then is their gas and electricity.
Yeah.
Well, those guys on the big bloody fat salaries that they would be on wouldn't be on a meter.
No.
So there you are.
Yeah. Wait, we're talking about the councillors getting all these things. I got you, yeah.
Yes.
Now, get this. When I talk to the people that the card goes to,
yes,
right, I was told that three particular shops do not charge 50 cents. Mm. When I rang them up and said, hi, I'd like to pay my bill by card. I wondered if you had a machine. They said, yes, we do. Absolutely. Can I pay my gas and electricity? Yes, you can. Just a reminder, there's a 50 cent charge. Oh, okay. Well, the person on the other end of this phone says they don't charge at all.
Yeah.
They were caught. It's just like Jeremy Paxson or some... What is those people that go and catch people? You know?
Yeah, I know you're on.
You know?
It was a UK programme. They were on the motorbike. And your man that was driving the motorbike ended up getting done for social welfare fraud.
Do whatever.
Yeah.
What was the name? There was actually a TV show, was it, on a particular street as well?
Yes, it was in Liverpool, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's very good, actually. Yeah. I enjoyed that. Yeah. But
Never heard of it.
We should, it's very good.
Other programmes are available.
Other programmes were not available.
Now, so we...
So tomorrow night, anyway, is the start of the World Cup.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
For
4 weeks.
There's matches on...
Wait, can I just stop there and you can continue on?
Oh, did you know who...
Hold on a second.
Oh,
shh.
Do you know who's got the next World Cup? Do you know who's got the next World Cup?
Who got it? Morocco?
No! No!
Canada,
America,
and Mexico.
Yeah, do you know what they're going to have to do now? What? Right, the wall. He has to put new gates in it.
The Mexicans!
But you see, the thing is, he can't have the one-way gate system. There have to be a revolving
gate.
Can
I just make a suggestion?
Yeah.
You can.
Can we sack one or the other, please? Can we sack either all the football players and make the councillor football players so they get one salary? Or can we make all the football players councillors and sack all the councillors?
No, because the football players will want a buyout clause to the contracts.
You know?
But you see, the thing is, councillors now are just as bad as footballers because they're getting such big salaries, and the minute they get let go then, they're getting big massive bonuses, and then they're getting paid.
Now, we have gone around this...
Do you notice that, though? Do you know that?
What?
That your councillor.
Yeah.
Right, say he's in for a term of four years. Right?
Say hello
to
the
boys right?
On the 109X from Cavan to Dublin.
Hello to 109X.
Do you know, right, if when...
That's Mike Wilson from Finn F. That's Finn Valley FM radio.
Oh, hello, Finn Lally.
When the next local election comes around and they don't get in, you know they get a pension.
Do they?
Yeah. And it keeps getting paid.
Finn,
and it keeps getting paid.
Mike,
keeps getting paid.
Can I go with you guys instead? Can I please? Now, listen to me, Jerry. You have been going round and round and round all night, like a drain. But I would like to say it's more like a roundabout.
Yes.
Would you like to roundabout what it is?
Right. As you're coming
around the way of it. We go around this subject.
As you're coming into Carlo from my end, which is the M9 end.
Okay.
As he's coming in from...
Shalala?
Dublin.
Shalala, Tuller Road. Yeah.
That's not the M9, though.
Well, it's the M9 end.
No,
I crossed the bloody bridge coming over to it, right?
No, you didn't. You went under it.
Oh, well, I went over it. Anyway, beside the point. So, anyway, every time you hit a roundabout...
No, can I just stop you there?
Oh, Jesus Christ. No.
Listen to me. I don't know where you come from, right? Okay. But where I come from, we don't drive through roundabouts.
We go around them.
Hence the name, roundabout.
As you come around the roundabout.
Nobody in this country knows how to go around the roundabout either. You do
as
that.
You're coming around the roundabout.
Yeah. Not going through.
No matter what way you go, whether you come off of the first, second, third, junction.
Or subsequent junction.
Or whatever junction you want.
Other junctions are available.
There is a pedestrian crossing.
10 feet.
10 foot into it.
Now.
Which means that you've got to slam on in the middle of the thing to let some poor York cross the road.
Yeah.
But do you know,
why does the council do it?
Technically speaking, it's illegal to stop in the roundabout.
And a lady was...
And here's another one for you. Why I have the grudge on it. Does anybody in Carlow or any other county for that matter, does anybody know what a yellow box junction is?
No.
No. Can I just say something?
Does anybody know?
I was
what a yellow box junction is?
Listen to me.
Driving in the centre lane of a motorway.
When I finished the show the other night.
The outside lane.
Or the outside lane of a two-lane motorway.
Listen to me. The other night I was heading into town. And
you know that's actually supposed to be only for emergency vehicles.
Mm-hmm.
The outside lane on the motorway.
Yeah.
No, it's for overtaking.
So it's supposed to be for emergency vehicles. No. Yeah.
Now,
What the hard shoulders.
I was going in town the other day and I stopped in front of the yellow box. And the cars were coming out.
By 9 o'clock crew were coming on, by
the
way. Hello, hi.
And this guy's beeping behind me, telling me to move into the yellow box, and I'm not moving into the yellow box.
You actually technically can.
I cannot.
You can
if you're turning right. Not if you're driving straight, only if you're turning right.
The cars were coming down from Castle Street.
Unless your
exit
road is clear.
Yeah. The cars are coming down Castle Street and they're using the yellow box to get out onto the road, which is perfectly legal.
Yeah.
This guy's beeping me and beeping me and beeping me and beeping me. Why? I don't know. Because if I move forward, he's only going to move forward and there's no place for him to go. Because we're going in the same direction. So, green light goes anyway and I hit it at funeral speeds.
Yeah. Been there, done that.
And as soon as I got up to the end, I saw it just about turn red and I went straight on. I was green going straight through. But by the time I got to the other side, it was red for him. All I saw was every single finger going up in the windscreen.
What's going on wrong?
Yes. He got stuck at the traffic lights.
Yeah. That's proper order.
That's proper order. Now, the second time that happened to me, listen, the second time it happened to me, right? If you beat me, you're in trouble. Because I will slow down to funeral speed for you. And I will make sure that your 5 minute journey will take 40 minutes to go across Carlow Town. I will. I've done it before. All the way from Perry's Cash and Carry to Earol.
Well, the Cash and Carry's
are available.
Well, Perry's isn't anymore.
The old
down.
One.
Yeah.
It's the old one, yeah.
And it took us, I'm telling you, 42 minutes to get from one side of town to the other side of town, and he couldn't get anywhere.
Which is about right.
Yeah.
Right. Learn to drive is my advice, okay?
Yeah.
Never
no,
beep
actually,
at me.
Actually, what it is really, is just learn
the
rules of the road.
Yeah.
We're now going HD.
Right, you know what? I got songs here, right? Up until 10:05.
Yeah, now we've got HD.
10:05 tonight. Do you know that? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut down a couple of songs here.
You're going to cut down to one and then say good luck. Because I'm coming up next.
Right, listen to me. I'm going to play two songs. I didn't choose them. They were in there already.
I think you're about waiting for me to go on there.
Mikey, wrong song, please. Who's that? Mikey, round song, please.
Don't know.
What is that? Play White Christmas. Hold on. Wasn't he the guy?
Yeah.
What? He's,
yeah. That's Finn Valley FM.
Oh, that's who that is. Hello,
yeah,
Finn Valley.
They're actually playing all Christmas songs in Donegal.
Well, he is tonight.
Well, listen.
We start bombarding them with text messages.
Listen, Finn Valley, I have a song right here for you. Check it out here on 88.1.
FM.
Well, we'll put in a point as well, just to make a point of it.
Very soon to be 90.
Yeah.
Oh, your TARDIS. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
we might have enough room for one song called Doctor Doctor.
No, that's we plan on moving the frequency, Doctor.
Yeah, listen, regarding frequency now, right?
Yeah.
I've got one big old style radio and you can tune it manually. But I also have another radio home that you can't tune manually, it will not go near 88. The only one to go is Spirit FM, which is before Radio 1. It won't go below that.
No,
now,
Spirit FM is between RT1 and 2FM.
Right, actually, yeah, I heard before that as well,
yeah.
So, so I think somewhere in the 90s might be more appropriate for us.
Oh yeah, that's what we're doing.
Definitely.
I have to look into change the frequency on 1.5.
I think definitely.
Next week or two.
But yeah, can I just advise? You know the way you can do these Facebook things? Where are you, Damien? I suppose I know what Damien's saying. You do it.
Yeah.
You know the way you can do the flashcards? If you're going to do whatever, put a flashcard up every hour. At 3 FM. Check it out.
Yeah.
You know? Really accurate. I only advertised on about 30, 40, 50 sites and I got over a 5,000 mark. To the 10,000 mark.
Over a million now.
Next thing we know, we're like 7.5 million.
Yeah.
Cool. What she said. Hey Mike, would you go away Tinkerbell and chat up all the men?
Yeah.
Are
available. Oh, what a nice night for it.
Depends on what you want to do.
There we are.
We are coming up to...
Good night.
Good night, nearly. We are coming up now to 4 minutes. No, let's have a look. 5 minutes to the hour. Jerry is up next with his Carol Country and his Toblerone and his coffee and they're not even marshmallows, they're charmallows. Did you know that?
They're all the ones.
Charmallows. Charmallows. They're charmallows.
Other sweets are available.
Well, they're not like that, they're not, they're called marshmallows.
Hi, Jahu, I know Jafar.
Doctoring in the TARDIS by the Time Lords, 1989.
What's he doing
in the classic TARDIS? Tune. Sorry, what now?
Who's he doing in the TARDIS?
Who's he doing in the TARDIS?
Oh, I don't know. He's probably doing Rose.
Rose
would
play
Billy Piper. Billy
yeah.
Piper. Man, but you know what? Something happened to Billy Piper over the years. She got this kind of weird kind of bite thing. But have you ever seen her in another show? Well, she plays the hooker.
No, I didn't.
Holy God. For anybody who's a Doctor Who fan out there, well... Tent in trouser time! Good night, folks!
You going to play your last song? You still got
you're
six minutes.
You
know what?
Oh, I was going to play a song, but I was told I didn't have a song.
You
didn't
have
3 minutes.
I didn't have a song, so do you know what? I'm going to play a Summer Hit, even though we're meant to be slightly 80s. I'm going to play Bare Naked... Oh, God, there's a lot of Bare Naked Ladies tonight, isn't there? 1 week from now, Bare Naked Ladies. And that's me, done for the night. I'm out. And Jerry's up next. Damien's down next. And who knows where I am?
Hi.
That's good, Jim.
Jerry?
Oh. Good luck.
Are you sticking around or are you guys?
I'm going to head over. Right. I've used up all the force.
What's your head?
Oh! Fucking hell, you're trying to murder me, are you?
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, Damien, if you've given me that chair, I think my hoodie, I wouldn't have broken that thing.
Oh!
Legs cracking.
Other chairs are available.
Legs, unfortunately, are not.
No. or picture frames.
Or picture frames for that
matter. Well, you shouldn't have left the chair. There is a go to deals, right?
and get one of those little black boxes, cost $1.49. You can get all the stuff off the window and you can store it away and make it look like it's tidy. And it wouldn't have broken it.
Can't see the window. You can't see the window.
I can.
They
can. I would have broken it.
Well,
look at that, look. And look at this. How long has it been? How long has it been? How long has it been?
A week.
And there's still shards of glass.
Yeah, no. The RA2. Don't worry about it.
And now what is done up here? What have you done up here?
What's wrong? I don't know. Do you know what I do? I
haven't done anything.
I create a folder called Backpack, and I just throw everything in there.
Yeah.
And I keep the desktop here.
Alright.
That's the OCD. Oh, do you know what I need?
I'll give you an OCD later when you have to get rid of the duplicate songs and get rid of the numbers of the songs. When you have 2 terabytes to clean up.
Yeah.
One way easy doing it, just delete the whole lot and start from scratch.
Which is no, couldn't do that. We'd have no songs.
You have no songs whatsoever.
There it, you're coming up to it now. 30 seconds.
Yeah, but I've got nothing up here. Look.
Don't worry,
come
up in a minute.
What's up there that you need?
My page for Facebook.
Ah, you can still go live. Actually, you are live. I'll
walk
into
what?
20 seconds.
Let it go.
Oh, your song should kick in anyway.
Come on, lads, come on.
What you doing?
That's gone slow as hell.
You're on manual, not in... It should be on auto.
The clock has stopped.
The clock has stopped, look. The fuck, show me. Look, click on it.
I have.
The clock. Oh, for fuck's sake. Well, we're live here on Carlo FM Live. We're on Facebook. Don't worry about 88.1 FM. We're still coming back online in a few minutes. Next song up will be... I don't know that song.
Why me? It always happens to me.
It's okay. You're the whole system. I'm just a mouse.
What did you do to it?
Nothing. Oh, God. Is that the system that you paid for? Yeah.
That's every time. It's me. It's done. Why me, Lord?
Okay, can you explain something to me, Jerry?
Yes.
Why is it, and Damien, why is it that when I played Music Night, I did not get banned once by Facebook?
I don't know.
Oh, lads, we're back with you in a minute, lads.
We'll be back with you. Remember, you can join us again. Today,
oh, my God.
On Sunday.
Sake. Oh,
for the
my
Sunday night mixtape, where I will be playing everything from the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s. I'd probably a little white.
Go away, is it? Other ways, and other yokes are available. And we are idling and erroring, and there's an error on the bottom of that.
Text Carl FM on 085-167-6738. We play your music your way 24/7.
You're listening to Carl FM on 88.1. And online at www.carlofm.com.
Do you want to close it down and start up a fresh video? Right, lads, I am at home. I will talk to you during the week. Damien, enjoy your electric spice water.
Hey, lads.
Yeah, sir.
Yes, we did.
Brand new ship. He got enough. I'm proud to take.
They are, but the recording one wasn't fucking done either.
No, here you are.
We'll be back.
Yeah. I don't know why he's done this. Has to be the computer.
Okay. How do I get that back up so I can see everything?
What do you want to do?
That one, is it?
The one again? Yeah.
God, watch that.
I don't know.
Oh, mother of God, I don't know what that was. Anyway, come here. Good evening to you. Welcome along to Carlow Country. We are live on Carlow FM. We're live on Carlow Live FM. We're live on my page. We're live everywhere. We actually are live. Funny enough. We're not dead yet.
No, not yet.
Not yet. 0851 676738. If you want to get a little request played, you can do so. If you want to get anything played off of the Facebook page, as I said, Carlow Group page, we are checking all these, by the way, just in case. We are refreshing them all back up again. Thank you very much to Anthony, of course, for the Mayhem Show. Basically, that we just made a complete ass's roar of it. But yeah, listen, we do these things anyway. Like,
We have fun doing it. Andy doesn't like us doing it, but we enjoy it.
Yeah, we don't mind what we're doing. Anyway, that's about it. Anyway, here's a little bit of C.C. Cooper. Shortly as well. No reception available in Dublin. No reception available in Dublin. Whatever that means. Cherry, can you please play Cleona Hagen's McCarthy Party? We can. none above. Come on up here. Look a well big lad, hope you're that's Carl. Thank you very much. HD cameras make an awful difference. They one again. God, I'm just talking to the gang here on Facebook. If you are out there, you got Facebook out there, go to Carlo FM Live. And that, you can go to Ger O'Brien, of course, my own page. We're live up on that one. We're also live on the group pages of Carlo FM and the like page on Carlo FM. You will get us out there. Old-fashioned way, 085-167-6738. If you want a little request... as well, you could do that one as well if you want to do that. There's plenty of other ways of getting this as well. You don't know what way you can do us, but I wouldn't mind that. Listen, we check 88 there for me. Yeah, sure, whatever. Listen, whatever you want to do. Colin Hardy, hello, lads, etc. Yep, thank you, Colin. Up there above in Newry. Kristen Kelly down there. We play a little bit of Cleona Higgins, McCarthy's Party. We can do that for you. Down below in Limerick, we can do that for you as well. We'll do all that later on for you. There is no problem whatsoever. 085-167-6738 is the old-fashioned way of getting this if you want to do that one for you. Here's a girl, absolutely another one, that's going to be taking the place by storm very shortly. A beautiful, absolute version. We said it here on Monday night. It was a fantastic version of this song. This is Sabrina Fallon. This is Coal Miner's Daughter. Miner's Daughter.